warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Today we'll be talking about some of my experience with the Islamic societies during the Islamic week every year. I was invited to attend or to speak in three occasions, three Islamic society weeks in three universities, one in Keele University in Staffordshire, second in Warwick University near Warwick and Coventry and Birmingham, the third in actually Leicester University Islamic Society. And usually when I travel in the evening, I take a driver for me because I don't know what time I'm going to finish traveling, changing train and others, okay? And we usually agree with the Islamic Society people to pay for the driver and to pay for the transportation and everything. And the first university was Keele University, and they agreed for everything by email and by others. And by the time I arrived there, one of the young executives came to me and said, we cannot pay all this money to the driver, and we only can pay you maybe a third of the amount of this. I was a little bit shocked and upset for the mismanagement of the issue, plus the lack of transparency and the clarity from the brothers and sisters in Islamic Society. Anyway, after Maghrib prayer, I have to pray Maghrib and Isha, and to go to the lecture hall and to talk to the people there. And on the way, I found him, this young man, coming and having some banknotes in his hand. I'm putting it in my pocket as if he's trying to give me something to make me happy. This reminds me of some of the movies when actually a belly dancer used to dance and some people stand up and give her some money and put it under whatever you call it, her dress. I was a little bit upset. I didn't mind not to charge them for the driver, but I was a little bit upset of the lack of clarity and transparency from the young people. Anyway, the lecture hall was a little bit dark. It was not suitable for someone to stand up and speak. Its arrangement was not suitable at all. And the people, girls and boys, were not interactive, and they have to be told by the same young man, please do not ask people to interact with you. So anyway, I was surrounded by a lot of negative energy from the organizers. So my talk was not very exciting. I had someone with me, a 15 years old, who was the son, or the driver's son, which I agreed with his father to take him with me whenever I go, whenever he has the time, to try to pick on his brain and to teach him something. His report on this talk was not very good and very cool and very cold report. The second one was in Leicester University. When I went there, the hall was full of people, more than the people in Keele University. And the brightness of the lighting of the hall was there, and there's no restriction. And I was flying high with the audience, interacting with them, talking to them, acting to them, and. So the young man came back and told me, this is far more better than the other one which we traveled to a few days ago. The third one was in Warwick University, which is a top-notch university, which was a medical school and medical people. More people were attending in a hired hall as well. And in this one, I was more lively and vibrant. And the report which came from the young man, which is the driver's son, was this was excellent. It's far more better than the first two. And they usually ask him to report back to me on the comments, the questions, the reception, and all these sort of things of people. My lesson here, my reminder here, is for young people who are organizing something like this, please be transparent, be clear with your guests, whether the guest is a lecturer or the sheikh or a priest or whatever you call him or her, about everything. Do not surprise him or her, because this affects him or her negatively before they go and deliver their talk. And sometimes it evaporates. It evaporates the ideas and the thoughts and the dream that is trying to pass to you. Be transparent, be objective, don't be frank, be frank, and don't be hesitant to tell the speaker or the guests of honor what you have of limitation so he can help you or she can help you. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.